on the phone with us, boxing great Kendall Holt. He still spars, he still trains. Kendall, how you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling good. A little tired right now, but, you know, I'll be up 4:30 in the morning to start working.
All right, so we're going to keep this short. We're not going to shoot a documentary here. But first, did you see the fight yesterday with Crawford and Kell Brook?
I saw the highlights. I missed it. I was so upset. And then I didn't want to, I knew as soon as I turned, I put on Instagram, I was going to see all the highlights. And then as soon as I put on Instagram, I'm like, damn, I didn't want to see it because I wanted to watch the whole fight. I didn't want to hear nobody's opinions or nothing, but I saw the highlights and I was like, damn, that was some good-ass punches he landed.
Yeah, he smoked them. He did good. But did you have a fight, Crawford? Did you have a spar him?
Nah, I didn't even know about Crawford until he was in camp with Bradley. I didn't hear about him. Like, you know, by that time, like, you know, my career was kind of fading away when he started building his up.
Yeah, one person you did fight is Danny Garcia. What do you think about Danny Garcia, Errol Spence?
You know what? A lot of times, because Danny is a solid fighter, right? Like, everybody always tries to, everybody always thinks he's going to lose, but he always comes out on top. And I think this is the great matchup because, I mean, you know, with Spence, he has all the confidence, but you know, Danny doesn't go nowhere. Danny's right there. So I think this is going to be a great fight. I'm actually looking forward to this one.
Remind people, for those who have not followed your career, what are some of your biggest wins and biggest fights of your career?
Well, I mean, everybody still to this day posts my post a fight when I won the championship against Ricardo Torres. Every few months I get somebody post that, and millions of people tag me in it. So I guess that's the biggest. But
Their favorite.
That's their favorite. But I don't know. My favorite performance is when I beat Isaac Lashwayo. Like, Isaac was ranked in 2 weight classes. He was undefeated. He was ranked across the board in 2 weight classes. I came out and off his, 16-17 month layoff and just outclassed him. But that was my favorite performance. My favorite knockout win is when I fought David Diaz, because David Diaz was he was number 2 in the world. I was in shit. He was a former Olympian. So when I was talking a lot of shit, and then all of the boxing press, everybody says he's gonna be too aggressive for me, throw too many punches, and we see how that went.
Listen, a few things. First of all, I'm in the media and I get it wrong 90% of the time. Number 2, reporters always have a habit of picking the wrong guy. Everybody thought that Lomachenko was going to smoke Teofimo. I said it's
and
a 50.
I didn't think that.
Why?
I don't know. It was just a feeling. You know, I don't know. They got these so-called boxing experts that's always fucking wrong in boxing. But for the, like, my gut was telling me that he was going to win. Like, now, and when I saw it, I was like, look at this. Look at it. He looks so much bigger. I'm just like, Lomachenko, he's got to go back down and wait.
He probably will. He's thinking of coming back January. But what did you think of Gervonta Tank Davis's knockout over Leo Santa Cruz? That was a big knockout.
Man, let me tell you, one of these, like, I love these young fighters. All right, Tank, Primetime, Shakur. I love these fighters because Devin Haney, they're so excited. And every time I watch these guys, like, I always, you know, I stopped boxing when I was 31. So I'm like, damn, did I stop too early? Because every time I watch these guys, especially Tank, because Tank is so fucking explosive and I love it. And, you know, my last fight against Peterson, that was his first fight. And then I've actually seen him fighting amateurs in my hometown in Patterson. So, like, I've known him for a long time now. So, I mean, just to watch him with that power, that means exciting.
In the amateurs, a lot of people don't know this, but Tank was the star. So, you know, they have 3-4 rings. Every ring that he would move to, the crowd, the wave would move with him. What do you remember from watching Gervonta Davis in the amateurs?
What I remember is, the same thing you see in Gervonta now is just, he was exploding with confidence. And then you could just see that right from the start. And he fought Julian Rodriguez, who's undefeated right now in the pros. But, it was an exciting fight. You know, Gervonta lost his decision to Julian Rodriguez, but, I mean, it was a good fight.
Obviously, you're a big supporter of Tank. You're a big supporter of Teofimo. If they fight, who do you like in that fight?
Gervonta, boy. Come on.
Why?
I don't know, because I know Gervonta, so I'm biased. I'm biased. I know Gervonta personally, so I'm going with Tank. In the story.
Okay. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.